Hi, Miss Sandy. I am counting my kids' allowance money.
Oh, they get allowance.
Yeah, they do some chores around the house and they get some allowance.
Nice. Well, I just finished counting 150 Granada bucks. Our Granada kids pooled their money together in order to buy a well of fresh water for some people in Africa through World Vision.
How awesome!
I know.
Well, good job, kids. Well, we're so proud of you for putting your money together for other people's needs, and in this case, a well in Africa.
Amen.
That's awesome. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Boys and girls, do you get allowance for any chores you do around the house? Perhaps you have a chores chart on your fridge or on your door or on the wall to help remind you of things to do around the house.
Do you save your money for something to buy that's really important?
Hello, I'm Isaiah Drake.
And I'm Luke Drake.
And a little over a year ago, we started our very own pressure washing business. We've been using this opportunity to go around pressure washing house sidewalks and roofs and making a little bit of money. We're using this money to save up for things that we might need in the future, like a car.
Pokemon card.
A trampoline.
Computer.
Some pizza.
Junk food.
What is the longest that you have saved your money to buy something important? How long did you wait?
That's a good question. Waiting is very important, boys and girls. Often, we will work really hard for a long time if we know we will get something we really, really want at the end. Today, we will hear about a time Jacob worked for a man for 7 years so he could marry the man's daughter.
Ooh.
Boy, he must have loved her so much. But there's more to the story than that.
Tied up with strings.
God made each of us so unique and different, even when it comes to things we like or dislike. Let's talk about our favorite things. I'm going to say a topic, and we'll say our favorites, and you kids do the same. For instance, favorite dessert.
Chocolate.
Ice cream. Maybe pumpkin pie this season.
I guess so, if you're into fall things.
Mm.
What's your favorite sport to play, Miss Sandy?
Ooh, ping pong!
Ping pong it is!
How about you?
I like to play ping pong too. I like to play soccer and ping pong.
Soccer?
I can't choose a favorite. They're both great.
How about your favorite professional team to watch play?
Oh, that's easy.
What?
Golden State Warriors basketball.
Golden State Warriors?
Yeah, they're a fun team to play.
Who are they?
Fun team to watch. I don't want to play them. They're going to beat me for sure.
I'm going to choose the Chicago Cubs. Woohoo!
Okay, go Cubs!
How about favorite?
What's your favorite color?
Color? Oh, I think aqua.
Aqua. Turquoise.
That's the same thing.
No, it's not. It's different.
How about your favorite Bible character?
Ooh. There's plenty. I like Daniel a lot.
I like Hannah.
Hannah.
Mm-hmm.
I like Daniel. Okay. Favorite Bible story?
That's Jesus.
Jesus. Yes.
Jesus coming to earth to save us from our sins.
But he's on every page. He's on every page.
Yes.
It's fun to talk about our favorite things, truly is. Even though we have differences, people's feelings usually aren't hurt when we talk about favorite things.
Nope.
But what about if we talk about favorite people? Can people's feelings get hurt when we talk about favorite people or if we have favorite people?
Maybe, sometimes, yeah, I bet so. Well, God calls us to love all people and treat them really fairly and with lots of respect. Today's event shows us an example of what not to do.
Okay.
So listen carefully and see what that is, and don't do it.
Good morning, Granada kids. I'm Miss Deanne. Now let's say our new big picture question and answer together. Does God keep his promises? God always keeps his promises because he is faithful. Now that is great news. This gives me the encouragement I need to keep working hard every day. And I bet Isaac's son Jacob asked himself that question a lot while he was a shepherd. Take the answer with you wherever you go and whatever you do.
Good morning, Granada kids. I'm going to lead you in a fun game called Water the Sheep. First, you need to tape a circle in the middle of the room. I'm gonna use this table to demonstrate. It's gonna be about 18 inches wide. This will be your well. Form two teams, and each player is gonna get a sheet of heavy cardstock paper. See, it's thicker than normal. Your sheep will be these cute little paper wads. Aw, as you can see, they are two different colors. I have purple and red. Now, each team has its own color of sheep. Your teacher or parent will scatter the sheep around the floor, and teams must use their paper to fan their sheep to the well, like this. Now, whatever you do, make sure that you do not push it like that. That is cheating and against the rules of the game. You gotta use the wind, the power of the weight of the cardstock to blow the little sheep into the well. After a minute or two, the teams with the most sheep inside the well is the winner. Go ahead, give it a try. Way to shepherd those sheep. In today's Bible story, Jacob met Rachel while she was taking her father's sheep to the well for water. Jacob didn't know then that he would be spending a lot of time with sheep in his near future. Let's find out what happened.
Jacob traveled from Bethel toward his uncle Laban's land. He came to a well where shepherds were watering their sheep. The shepherds were from Haran. "Do you know a man named Laban?" Jacob asked. "Yes," they said. "Here comes his daughter Rachel with his sheep." Rachel brought the sheep to the well, and Jacob gave them water. Jacob told Rachel that he was her relative, a son of Rebekah. Rachel ran to tell her father Laban. Laban welcomed Jacob into his house. Jacob stayed with Laban and worked for him. After about a month, Laban said, "What should I pay you for your work?" Now, Laban had two daughters. The older was named Leah, and the younger was Rachel. Jacob loved Rachel, so he said, "I will work for you 7 years if you will let me marry Rachel." Laban agreed. Jacob worked for 7 years, but he loved Rachel so much that 7 years seemed like only a few days. Then Laban had a feast, but instead of giving Rachel to Jacob, Laban gave his older daughter Leah. Jacob was upset. "Why did you trick me?" he asked. Laban said, "Around here, the older daughter must be married before the younger. I will give you Rachel too, but you must work another 7 years." So a week later, Jacob married Rachel. Then he worked for Laban 7 more years. Now Jacob had two wives, but he loved Rachel more than Leah. When God saw Leah was not loved, he gave her children. Rachel wanted children too. God heard her prayer, and in time, God gave her children too. In all, Jacob had 12 sons: Reuben, Simeon, Levi, Judah, Dan, Naphtali, Gad, Asher, Issachar, Zebulun, Joseph, and Benjamin. God told Jacob to go home to the land of Canaan, so Jacob gathered his family and his possessions, and he headed home. Nothing could stop God's plan for the family of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Even though Jacob did not love Leah, God loved her and used her in his plan. Through the family of Jacob and Leah's son Judah, God would show his love for the world by sending his son to be the savior he promised.
Hello, boys and girls. As you know, I'm Granny, but I would like to talk with you as a mother because I'm that too. I am I'm sure that when Jacob's mother, Rebecca, sent him away, she expected him to be gone for a few days, just until Esau calmed down. Do you ever have to be separated from your brother or sister for a cool down time? But days passed, and then weeks passed, and then months passed, and then years passed. 21 years, even though Rebecca missed her son. I'm sure she did, because that's what we mothers do. It is wonderful to know that God is in control and always faithful to carry out his plan. You can remember that too.
Good morning, Granada kids. I'm Miss April. Our key passage comes from God's words to Jacob after he left home and when he went to sleep. God wants us to know that he is trustworthy and always keeps his promises. Let's say the words together. Look, I am with you and will watch over you wherever you go. I will bring you back to this land, for I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you. Genesis 28:15. Jacob probably thought about these words a lot during his time working with Laban. Let's think about these words too as we sing, and when we leave home each day, and even when we go to sleep.
Bible, we see that you love us so much, just as you love Leah. Even when others are unloving us, your love never changes. Help us to share your love with others, especially those who may feel lonely or misunderstood. And thank you for using Jacob and finally sending Jesus to bless through the whole world by dying on the cross for our sins. In his wonderful name we pray, amen.
What a great key passage that we get to learn this month. I love it. For this activity, stand in a circle or across from a friend or family member, and you're going to pass around this cute little sheep. As each person receives the sheep, they say the next word in the key passage, like this. Behold, you pass it to a friend. I, pass it to another. Am, pass it to another. With, pass it to another. You, and will keep you wherever you go and will bring you back to this land, for I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you. Genesis 28:15. You keep that cycle going, and each friend that gets to hold the lamb gets to say a word from the key passage. See how long it takes for you to get through the entire key passage. Then do it again and see if you could do it faster. Go ahead, give it a try. Our key passage is God's promise to Jacob, but as children of God, this becomes our promise too. How awesome. God will always be with us and watch over us, just as a good shepherd watches over his sheep.
Hey kids, so glad you were with us today. Hope you learned that nothing can power over God's plans. Nothing could stop God's plan for the family of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Even though Jacob did not love Leah, God loved her and used her in his plan to bless the world through Jesus. Leah's son, Judah, would eventually have a family of his own. And Jesus, the promised Savior, would come from Judah's family and save the whole world. Woo-hoo! That's awesome. Boys and girls, I hope you learn to trust in God and his plans, because they always come true. God bless you guys. Have a safe week. See you next time. Bye. Thank you.